So today we published the Exchequer Returns for 2015. The figures show tax revenue amounted to 45.6 billion for last year. That was a 10.5% increase relative to 2014, and that's consistent with an economy that grew last year in nominal terms by about 11%. All of the main tax heads recorded strong year-on-year growth. Income tax was up by about 7%, reflecting inter alia the recovery in the labour market, strong employment growth, some evidence of wages beginning to pick up. Consumption taxes, namely VAT and excise, were growing at around 6 or 7%, in line with the recovery in personal consumer spending. But the biggest increase was in relation to corporation tax, which increased by just under 50% in 2015. That reflects a number of factors, a strong performance by the multinational sector, reflecting a number of factors, including the depreciation of the exchange rate, but by and large, just improved trading conditions. At the time of the budget in October, we were projecting a deficit of 2.1% of GDP for last year. The stronger than assumed tax revenue, as well as a slight underspend on the expenditure side, mean that that deficit is now likely to be closer to 1.5% of GDP rather than the 2.1% of GDP originally envisaged. For 2016, most but not all of the improved revenue feeds through. So we expect, instead of a deficit of 1.2% of GDP, which was the original target for 2016, the deficit will now be closer to 0.75 percentage point of GDP for this year. The debt ratio has come down fairly rapidly in recent years. It peaked at just over 120% of GDP in 2013, and last year came below 100% of GDP for the first time since 2010. And this year we expect a further reduction in the debt to GDP ratio, coming in somewhere around 93% of GDP.